As a pilot, managing flying schedule and maintaining sleep quality can become challenging. Simply sleeping 8 hours isn't enough. The quality of sleep plays a vital role in cognitive functions. Irregular sleep can have significant damage on human body, both in short term as well as long term. In his book, Why We Sleep, Dr. Matthew Walker mentions drowsy driving is responsible for vehicle accidents as much as driving under the influence, if not more. So, here is top 5 hacks that I use as a pilot to improve the quality of sleep. On a side note, this can be useful for anyone who doesn't have the luxury of going to bed at a fixed time. Let's say I have a flight departure at 2:30 in the morning tomorrow. 2 hours for shower, transport, and airport paperwork. Bedtime alarm has more priority than wake-up alarm. As soon as my roster is out for next month, I usually set my sleep schedule up in the calendar. So, my bedtime alarm would be set for departure minus 10 hours, that is 4:30 p.m. I'll be going to bed. Melatonin management. No, I don't mean external melatonin supplement, but our body produces melatonin when environment is relatively darker. So, in order to manage melatonin, I just avoid exposure to bright white light, departure minus 12 hours or 2:30 p.m. in the afternoon. This includes measures like avoiding mobile screen activity, dim yellow lights in the house, or blackout curtains, etc. Third, body temperature regulation. If the core body temperature drops a little, it is easier to fall asleep. For this, I keep the bedroom temperature between 20 to 22 degrees Celsius. Having a hot shower is another way to drop core body temperature before bed. You can do both. Avoid sleep interruption. If for any reason, after sleeping at 4:30 in the afternoon, if I wake up for any reason at 6 in the evening, I know I'm not going to be able to sleep again. And hence, I avoid fluid intake 2 hours before bed. Having a pinch of salt right before bed can help. This increases the water retention, but you don't have to wake up in the middle of the sleep to pee. Tea, coffee, and other stimulants. Caffeine has half-life of 5 hours. My caffeine tolerance is about 80 milligram per day or 2 cups of coffee. So I would stop drinking coffee or tea around 6 hours before bedtime. If I have a flight on minimum rest period, I try to avoid caffeine altogether to avoid caffeine crash. As aviation is growing, pilots are flying on minimum rest periods and hence could be exposed to health risks associated with fatigue or sleep deprivation. These few simple tips have served me well to maintain my health so far, and I hope it serves you well too. Let me know in the comments what works best for you. Please note that this is not a medical advice, but only a lifestyle modification in order to cope with dynamic needs of pilot career. I wish you a healthy sleep.